So, what is self-inductance, or also known as electrical inertia? Self-inductance can be described as follows. Self-inductance is a tendency of a coil to resist the changes in current in the current itself. So what does that mean? So if you think about this coil, which is a copper coil, let's say, and this coil has n number of turns, and it has the length of L, and also the radius inside the coil core, let's say it is R. And in this coil, we apply a voltage, which is a change in voltage specifically, to change the current inside the coil. So when the current changes inside the coil, and it generates a reactance voltage to react to the voltage changes that is happened inside the source. So this property, what this coil does, or the solenoid does, what we call as electrical inertia, or we known as self-inductance. So now we can find the self-inductance that is generated inside the coil. To find that, first we have to find the magnetic field that is inside the coil. So thus, we have to use Amperes' law. So using Amperes' law, we get the magnetic field inside the coil times the total length of the coil. We say dl, integral of dl, so that we get the total length of the coil equals to the permeability inside the core of the coil times the current that is flowing through the wire. So Amperes' law is only described for a single loop. So if we have multiple loops, in this case a number of loops, we have to multiply this Amperes' law by n for the total number of loops we have inside the coil. So if we substitute the values, B, the total length of the coil will be L, and mu, I, times n, which is the number of coils, number of loops inside the coil. And if we substitute the value B, we get mu I n divided by L. So in this case, we have an air core. We say it's mu naught, just for the fact it is air. So now that we have the beta, or magnetic field, inside the core, now we can find the self-inductance inside the coil using Faraday's law. So let me take some space, like so. And now I'm going to use the Faraday's law to find the self-inductance of the coil. Faraday's law explains that the EMF generated by the coil is proportional to the magnetic flux that changes over time times the number of turns in the coil. And we have to put minus sign in the front because the generated EMF goes in reverse to the voltage source. So therefore we use Faraday's law, EMF equal minus n d phi over dt. And now we know that phi equals BA. B is the magnetic field, and A is the area encircled by this coil. So if you replace that, and then we get BA dt. And now We already found B equals mu naught I n over L, and A is simply the area of the encircled by the coil. R would be phi r squared. So if we replace that, we get minus n d mu naught I n pi r squared, and then we divide all of this by L, and we have dt. And if you simplify this a little bit more, we get EMF mu naught pi r squared over L. So all of these things that take out of the derivative would be a constant. Only I changes over time, because I is the current. Since current changes over time, that's why coil changes its magnetic field. So it changes. So that's why we calculate self-inductance. So DI needs to be a changing factor, and this is the constant for the equation. So now we say that this constant part of the equation that we found is the self-inductance. We say that's L of the coil. So we write n squared mu naught pi r squared pi r squared over L. So this is self-inductance. And if you take a look at this equation number one, we have L times di over dt. So we can replace that L as follows: di over dt. So this equation says that if we change current that is running through the coil rapidly, that means we get huge impulse of EMF as the amount of change that happens in the di over dt. So that's about it. This is the EMF that is generated by the coil, and this is the self-inductance of the coil. See you next time.